hard to do. Tried hard to imagine the way you felt in DC. From Westeros to Nova Scotia, you should have held it. Good evening, everybody. My last video of the day, I promise. I'll stop spamming everybody. I wanted to do my first proper review. I haven't actually reviewed anything yet, so I was going to just do a real quick one before I went to sleep here. And that's on Samuel Gewiss 1792 Flake. It's also sold, I think, also sold as Cob Flake in Europe. I bought it sight unseen, never tasted it, never tried it before, bought 250 grams of it. And cellared it, and I've been smoking on it now intermittently for the past few months. I wanted to give you kind of my impressions. This is one that is going to fall into one of two categories. I love it or I hate it. There is not a lot of middle ground. You look on tobaccoreviews.com, a lot of 4 stars, a lot of 1 and 2. No 3, no, I kind of like this sometimes, but, and that thing that divides that is the flavoring, which I'll talk about in a second. It's a full-bodied, fire-cured Kentucky, I think it's a Tanzanian leaf, along with some Virginia for a little tang and pepperiness. It's not a bright, citrusy, sweet Virginia. And so those two things are going to cause it to be very dark, very deep, very heavy, creamy on the mouthfeel. The flavoring, and this doesn't really qualify as an aromatic, although it wood goes to pipe, so be careful, is Tonkin bean, T-O-N-Q-U-I-N. I know it as tonka bean, T-O-N-K-A. It's an herbal vanilla, basically. Think of it that way. It's it's an alternative to vanilla that's used in a lot of fragrances, and that's kind of another thing that I follow quite regularly as far as reviews, fragrance reviews, men's fragrance reviews, and so I see a lot of tonka bean, and in fragrances it comes out as a very creamy vanilla, very warm, inviting scent. Tobacco does not translate that well with tonka bean, because it causes it to be a little sour. And that's the flavoring is going to be where people say I like it or don't like it. It's all going to come down to that. Because there are other Irish Flake is kind of similar to me in mouthfeel and body. Very full body, very dark, but it's not flavored, and that's where this. So tonka bean in the tobacco is going to come across as very sour. Occasionally, I get a little floral, which may or may not be the Lakeland essence. I think Gilworth and Hogarth are probably more known for the Lakeland essence with the floral note. But occasionally, it'll come down here, depending on the pipe and depending on how hot this stuff gets. That's another thing. Preparation of this is key. It's a flake. It's very dense. It's very moist. Even with breaking it up and crumbling it and working in your hands, you're still going to have large pieces in there, which you think would burn cool, but that's not necessarily the case because you have to pull so hard to keep this stuff lit. So it's going to require some dry time. Plan ahead for this one. It's going to be an after-dinner smoke, so if you know you're going to have a full dinner one evening, and you want to enjoy this stuff, plan ahead. Give it a few hours dry time, spread it out thin, and let it air. The fold and stuff method as far as flakes go, not going to work with this one, I don't believe. I think you'd have too hard of a time keeping it lit. You need an extra set of lungs to do your charring light, and probably a vacuum to help do the puffing for you. So think ahead on this. Not something you're going to be able to just load up and go. So a lot of preparation. And a flavoring that you're either going to love or hate. That's two strikes against you, really. So my advice to you on this, I can't really give this a full recommendation. I like it personally because it's unique. What you're going to want to do is buy no more than 50 grams of this stuff. If you can get a smaller sample of that or you know somebody who has it, do that first. Because right away you're going to know, oh, I like this, I don't. As far as your pipe choice for this, go with something with a thick bowl because it does tend to burn a little hot despite being fairly large particulate. Other than that, I would choose a small bowl simply because it's very strong. That fire cured leaf is going to be very strong in nicotine content. So that's kind of the long and short of it. And you see this dark, voluminous smoke. That is Carter Hall. That's my leftover Carter Hall from earlier today. You're not going to get a huge volume of smoke from 1792, and you're going to have a tendency to want to puff it hard to keep it going. So it's one of these that's really going to require a lot of attention, a lot of technical cadence and everything else. And I'm not really good at that, but a lot of people are, and I'm sure you'll probably do much better with it than I do. Still like it, and I still got plenty of it, so very good. I can give it a recommendation personally, but I think you're going to need to try it, because that Tonkin is going to make all the difference for you. So that's my review of Samuel Goeth's 1792 Flake. Take a look. There's a lot of other YouTube reviews online. I think you'll find that people say much the same thing. So, hope that helps. For those of you who've already tried it, let me know in the comments what you think of it and how you find it. I'm be curious to see what people have to say. I'm sure people are gonna. Some people with some more nuanced palates are probably gonna pick up some more complexity. It's not very complex. It's fairly linear smoke from bowl to bowl and from the top of the bowl all the way to the bottom. I don't pick up a lot of different flavors from this, which is to be expected. It's basically two component parts with the flavoring. So, anyway, I hope you guys have a good evening. All right, see ya. A real quick afterthought here. I wanted to do just kind of a brief addendum to what I'd said earlier. Tonka bean, and did a little research, has coumarin in it. Coumarin is what gives it sort of its sweet vanilla sort of flavor. And in perfumes and fragrances and anything that's kind of aromatic, that's what gives it its kind of wonderful vanilla sweet smell. However, in food additives and tobacco, it can give a very bitter taste, so I think that's probably where people are going to come into that. And the other thing is coumarin. It's in a specific class, and it can be used as precursor molecule for anticoagulants, most notably one called warfarin or coumadin is the brand name, and that is potent anticoagulant that we use for people as a blood thinner for people who've had blood clots and specific heart conditions. So it's been banned in certain foods. It can't be used in certain cosmetics and food additives and that sort of stuff simply because it can cause damage to the liver. So, buyer beware. I don't know, then I can't find anything about its specific health effects, although it's considered a lung-specific carcinogen. So, it can't be used in cigarettes anymore, but it's still in pipe tobacco. Take that for what you will. I think your risk is pretty low, but it's definitely there. So anyway, that's my addendum. Thanks. And I won't forget to put roses on your grave. No, I won't forget to put roses on your